Okay, now take one more example. Examine the convergence of the series. Examine the convergence of the series. The series is 5 minus 4 minus 1 plus 5 minus 4 minus 1 plus 5 minus 4 minus 1 and so on and so on. Now solution. What is the given series? Let it be sigma an equal to 5 minus 4 minus 1 plus 5 minus 4 minus 1 plus 5 minus 4 minus 1 and so on. Okay, right? And to decide the convergence, divergence or oscillation, what we have to consider? The sum of nth partial sum. So nth partial sum is Sn. What is Sn? Sum of first n terms. So let me consider sum of first n terms. And what is the last one also? 5 minus 4 minus 1. Since this term is repeated, 5 minus 4 minus 1, 5 minus 4 minus 1, 5 minus 4 minus 1, I'm taking this 5 minus 4 minus 1 together as single term. Okay. So these are how many terms? The sum of first n terms. First n terms. Just wait. Now, sum of first n terms. What is this value? Now, this is a sequence. Sequence of nth partial sum is what? Here, Sn is a sequence of nth partial sums. Sequence of nth partial sums. Therefore, when sequence convergent or divergent, take limit. Limit Sn as n tends to infinity. Limit Sn as n tends to infinity. Here, how this limit, limit is passing through what? Passing through 5 and first term, second term, third term, fourth term up to infinity. So if I consider three terms together, these three terms together, right? Next to four terms, that means for, I will write like this, 3n terms. That means what is the value if I consider n is starting from 1, 2 and so on. So first three terms, what is the answer? 0. If I take n equal to 2 here, n equal to 2 here, then six terms. What is the six term? Sum of the first six terms also, it is also 0. Sum of the nine terms, it is also 0. So 0 for 3n terms and 3n plus 1 terms. 3n plus 1 terms, that means 3 plus 1, 4. Right? Fourth term. Next one, again, n equal to 2 means seventh term. Like that. So what is the fourth? If I take first four terms, the value is 5. This is 5. When I consider 3n plus 1 terms, this is for 3n plus 1 terms. And the next one is, if I consider 3n plus 2, one more, this is 3n plus 2 terms. For 3n plus 2 terms means up to here. When n equal to 1, 5 terms. 5 terms means where, up to where? This is 3 plus 2. So this is 0, 5 minus 1, that is 5 minus 4, 1. Next term is what? 3n plus 3. 3n plus 3 is nothing but what? 3n plus 3 is nothing but what? If I take 3 common, this is again 3 into n plus 1, which coincides with again 3n. Therefore, only three possible choices are there. What are those choices? 3n terms, 3n plus 1 terms, and 3n plus 2 terms. Then what is the limit value? Since limit n tends to infinity Sn is finite but not unique, right? Having finite value is having finite but not unique, the sequence Sn, the sequence Sn oscillates finitely. Okay, see, oscillation means not only between two values, many other values also. Therefore, what is the series also? The series sigma n also oscillates finitely. Okay, this is one problem based on oscillation. Now, if I consider one more problem, just to understand this concept sum of nth partial sums, you take test the convergence of the series 1 by root n, sigma 1 by root n. So what is the answer here? Sigma a n equal to, the series is sigma 1 by root n, n is always from 1 to infinity, so 1 by 1, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 3, and so on, 1 by root 3 and so on. Then what is the sum of nth partial sum? Then the first sum of n terms, 1 plus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 3 and so on. What is the next term? This is 1 by root 1. That means last nth term is 1 by root n. Can anybody tell what is the summation value, sum of first n terms? Do it on the paper. Is it audible? Hello?
Yes, sir, it's audible.
Okay. What is the sum? Anyone? If any problem in internet, please call me. Okay. Because I'm in college, the net is very slow. Okay.
Sir, inequality.
What?
Inequality.
Inequality. Yeah, tell. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, 1 by root 1 greater than 1 by root n.
Still you people are joining now after 10 minutes. Okay, yeah. What is this? Sn is equal to 1 by root 1 plus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 3 and so on. 1
sir,
by root
infinity?
No, the only n terms are there, na?
Sir, not, Sn is...
I'm not taking...
Sir,
n
is... Hello, sir? Ah,
yeah, yeah.
Sn is n plus root n by 2.
N plus?
Root n by 2.
How you get?
Like Sn is sum of the series a n by 2 into a plus l first term plus last term. Using that formula, you can get...
No. Somebody told inequality. What is that? See, this 1 is greater than 1 by root n. I am comparing every term with this last term. 1 by root 2 is greater than definitely 1 by root n. 1 by root 3 is greater than 1 by root n. Like that. Okay, what you will get here? This is greater than first term 1 by root n and second one 1 by root n. And lastly, this before term is also 1 by root n. Okay. And what is the last one? 1 by root n is equal to 1 by root n. So that term as usual. That term I'm writing as usual. Up to here only the greater than valid and plus something. This plus something means this is every term is more than this 1 by root n. So obviously this entire is greater than this value. So what is this? It's total n terms are there, n by root n. That is equal to root n. Therefore, what is the value of Sn? The value of Sn is greater than root n. The value of Sn is greater than root n. Therefore, what is the limit value then? If I consider limit, limit s tends to infinity means what? Limit n tends to infinity root n. That is equal to infinity. Limit Sn is greater than infinity is nothing but again infinity. So clearly, what is the limit of Sn as n tends to infinity? Is infinity. That means what? The sequence Sn is divergent. The sequence Sn is divergent. Therefore, the corresponding series also divergent. Now, in this problem, you had some problem. How to get the sum of the first n terms, right? somewhat difficult. You will not get directly this greater than 1 by root n, greater than 1 by root n value. It is not always possible to get similar ideas, isn't it? Right? So there is a problem. There is a problem. Always there is a problem. How to find some of the first n terms in the series? What is that value? So it is a typical one. So to avoid that, to avoid, the point is to avoid the complexity, to avoid the complexity in finding the value of SN, some theorems were developed to test the convergence of the series. Okay, now always remember, whatever these testing of convergence using nth partial sum in examination, don't do this except this oscillation problem. For remaining problems, there are so many theorems are there where you can tell directly whether the given series is convergent or not. Always remember, convergence is most important for our problem. Divergence is not at all important. Okay, so all tests were developed only for the convergence. Okay, the first one, the first test is geometric series test. Geometric series test. Geometric series test. What is the statement here? Let the series be sigma an equal to 1 plus, one can take x or some, let me take r, 1 plus r square and so on, and r to the power of nth term, n minus 1 plus and so on in a finite series. Then let the series be this one, which is geometric series with common ratio what? Clearly, with common ratio r. Then the first point is sigma an, the geometric series is convergent. Sigma an is convergent if the common ratio is less than 1. Common ratio is taken in modulus, okay, less than 1. Second one, the series sigma an is divergent if the common ratio is greater than or equal to 1. Common ratio is greater than or equal to 1. And third one, sigma an is oscillates if the common ratio r is less than or equal to negative 1. Modulus is not there because negative values are there, less than or equal to minus 1. You remember this always. Remember, what is that? This is a geometric series with common ratio what? R. If the common ratio is less than 1, then series is convergent. Common ratio is greater than 1, divergent. Equal to 1, divergent. When common ratio is less than or equal to 1, negative 1, then series is oscillate series. Okay, just briefly, actually no need of proofs in examination. Just beginning kada meer andaru proofs gurinchi idu etlo chindi anukuntaru. That is why I'm telling a fast proof of this geometric series test. What is the series here? What is the series? Like sigma an is given as 1 plus r square and so on. And what is the nth term? R power n minus 1. See, nth term is what? R power n minus 1, not r power n, because this 1 power 0, r power 0, 0 to n minus 1. How many terms? N terms. So the nth term will be what? R power n minus 1. Remember this. Consider the sum of first n terms as usual. The property, sum of first n terms. What is that? Sum of first n terms, Sn. So sum of first n terms. So 1 plus r square. And what is the nth term? R power n minus 1 is in GP, geometric progression with the common ratio, with the common ratio R, with common ratio R. So what is the summation formula, anybody? Geometric progression, sum of n terms.
A into R power n minus 1 by R minus 1.
Yes, A into 1 minus R power n by 1 minus R, or A into R power n minus 1 by R minus 1. What is the A value here, starting value? 1. So this is, I will write 1 minus, common ratio is R, n terms are there, R power n by 1 minus R. This is my SN. This is my SN. Now, what is, if sequence SN converges, then geometric series also converge. Diverge, diverge. Therefore, I have to find limit of this value. Limit of this value. So case one, if I consider case one, what is that? Mod R less than one. What is the case one? Mod R less than one. Mod R less than one means, see all of you, the common ratio value is less than one. Less than one means, let me consider, for example, 0.1. Then what is R square? 0.01. What is R cube? 0.001. That means, what is R power n as n tends to infinity? If I increase this power n, this is R power 1, 0.1, R power 2, 0.01, R power 3, 0.001, R power 4, 0.001. So it is tending to what? Zero. When R less than 1, 0. Right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Then when mod R is less than 1, then what is the limit of n tends to infinity, R power n? It tends to what? 0. Therefore, take this as one expression. Therefore, limit of SN as n tends to infinity. This is limit 1 minus R to the power of n by 1 minus R. Clearly, what I am taking, R value is less than 1. So formula is 1 minus R power n. If R value is greater than 1, then R power n minus 1. So what is this becomes? This is limit is applicable only for n terms. Therefore, 1 minus, okay, limit R to the power of n tends to infinity by 1 minus R. So what is this value? 1 by 1 minus R is value. What is R? Means common ratio. It is a finite value. And 1 by 1 minus R finite, and what is this? Unique value. Finite and unique value. Therefore, the sequence SN is what? Convergent. Sequence SN is convergent. Therefore, series also converge. Series also converge. This is the case one. Any doubts? Yeah. Next, second case, mod R greater than R equal to 1. Mod R greater than R equal to 1. Then, since mod R greater than 1, let me consider greater than 1. Greater than 1 means what? If I take R value some 2 or 1.5, something, R square 4, R cube 8, like that, what is the R power n value as n goes to infinity? It is tending to infinity.
Infinity.
Therefore, infinity. In mod R greater than 1, what we have? Limit n tends to infinity, R power. For n term, limit R power n, and you have to write like this. You have to write like this. First, R power n term, because R value is greater than 1. R value is greater than 1, R power n minus 1 by R minus 1, you have to write. Okay. Therefore, this is infinity minus 1 by R minus 1. That value is infinity. Limit SN value infinity means what? Sequence SN is divergent sequence. Divergent. When sequence divergent, the series is also what? Divergent. Series is divergent. This is R greater than 1. This is R greater than 1. Now, for R equal to 1, in this second case, two choices, R greater than or equal to 1. Greater than 1, we proved the series is divergent. So for equal to 1, when for R equal to 1, what is sigma an becomes? 1 plus R square plus and so on. Isn't it? R value 1. Therefore, What is Sn becomes? Sum of first n terms only. Sum of first n terms only plus n. How many terms? N terms. So what is this value? N. So what is the limit Sn value? As Sn tends to infinity, infinity. That means the sequence Sn is divergent. Sequence Sn is divergent means the series also divergent. Series also divergent. Okay, is that clear? Right? And the third one, oscillation. What is the oscillation? R is less than or equal to negative 1. R is less than or equal to negative 1. Now here, let me consider first R equal to negative 1. When R equal to negative 1, what is sigma n? The series becomes what? 1 plus R minus 1 plus R square plus 1 minus R cube and so on like that. Isn't it? Right? So what is Sn then? What is Sn becomes 1 minus 1 plus 1 and so on. And what is this last term, nth term?
0.
When n equal to 1, positive 1. When n equal to 2, yes, summation. So what is this value? Power n minus 1. Power n minus 1, n terms, 1 power 0 to this 1 power. And coming to this limit value, what is this becomes? Limit Sn, as I told you in the previous problem, this is either plus 1 or minus 1. If n is odd here, and when n is even, sorry, when n is even 0. If n is even 0. When n is odd means, when n equal to 1, 1. When n equal to 3 also, 1. When n equal to 5, 1. When n is even, even means 2. 2 terms. If I take 2 terms, sum of first 2 terms, 0. Sum of first 4 terms, 0. So, limit Sn value is either 1 or 0 according to n odd or even. This implies sequence n oscillates finitely. Oscillates finitely. Right? That implies series sigma an also oscillates finitely. Oscillates finitely. When r is less than negative 1. And it's a. Who is this? Sujit Reddy? Yes. Sujit Reddy, please speak up. Sujit Reddy, just now you joined. Matladava. Now, when R is negative, less than minus 1. R is less than minus 1 means what? R is negative. R is definitely something. Let me take minus R equal to minus rho. Then R equal to minus rho. So that rho value is greater than 1. Correct? This implies what? R is negative now. Definitely rho value is greater than 1 because R is negative. Then what is r power n becomes? R power n becomes minus rho whole power n. That is minus 1 whole power n into rho power n. Then what is nth partial sum? What is nth partial sum formula? 1 minus r to the power of n by 1 minus r. 1 minus r power n becomes now what? Because it is negative. This by 1 minus r becomes 1 plus rho. Becomes 1 plus rho. Now, if I take limit Sn as a tends to infinity, obviously, what is this? One can write limit. This is n tends to infinity minus 1 n rho over n. Since rho is what? Rho is what? Greater than 1. Since rho is greater than 1, rho power n tends to infinity. As n tends to infinity, then so this value is what? Since minus 1 whole power n is there, so n is tending to infinity. When n is tending to infinity through odd numbers, this is negative. minus 1 whole power n becomes negative when n passing through order. Negative and this negative becomes positive. Therefore, plus infinity if n is odd. When n is even, this becomes positive 1 and this minus is there. Therefore, minus infinity if n is even. Minus infinity if n is even. That implies sequence Sn oscillates. Sequence Sn oscillates infinitely. Sequence Sn oscillates infinitely. That implies sigma An also oscillates infinitely. Oscillates infinitely. This is geometric series test. Is that this geometric series test? Common ratio is less than 1 converges. Common ratio is greater than 1 diverges. Equal to 1 diverges. And common ratio is less than or equal to minus 1. Less than or equal to minus 1, then diverges. Less than or equal to minus 1, then diverges. One example, a small example. A lot of examples we involve this geometric series in further problems. But to understand the concept, one problem. Test the convergence of the series 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 square, 1 by 3 cube, and so on. And so on. Okay, what is the common ratio here? Here, this series is in GP, correct? This series in GP with the common ratio. With the common ratio, what is the R value?
Minus 1 by 3.
Negative 1 by 3, correct? Yes? R value, negative 1 by 3. Yeah, this implies what is mod R? 1 by 3. Mod R, 1 by 3 is less than 1. Isn't it? Okay, therefore, what is the series is? Convergent. Series is convergent. Okay, a simple example. Later on, you will get so many problems. Now, let us see properties of series. This is important, okay? Because in deciding convergence and divergence of the series, general properties of series, we need these properties. Is video is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
General properties of series, the first one. What is the first one? See, the properties of series means these are axioms. Do you know what is axioms? Axioms means what? Self-proofs. Proofs does not exist. The statement itself, it's proof. Okay, that is called axiom. The first one is the convergence or divergence of an infinite series. Convergence, divergence of an infinite series remains unaffected. Remains unaffected. Remains unaffected by the addition. By the addition or removal, by the addition or removal of a finite number of terms, finite number of its terms, finite number of its terms. What is the statement here? See, for example, some series is there, sigma an equal to something, a1 plus a2 plus and so on. Infinite series is there. If for this series, if I add some more terms, for example, I'll add a naught plus a minus 1, a1 plus a2 and so on. Let us add two terms here, or you can add some more terms. If I add some finite number only, finite number, not infinite number. If I add finite number of terms to the series, then the behavior of the series does not affect it. Means, if the series is convergent and if I add some 10 terms, 10 or 11 terms to that series, then convergence does not affect it. Same is true for divergence also. Okay. And the next one is, if in the series, a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus and so on. If I remove some number of terms, for example, I will consider sigma an from a5, a6 and a10, a100, like that. That means I have removed some finite number of terms from the series. Then the convergence or divergence remains unaffected. Remains unaffected. This is the first property. So for or for a divergence, if some finite numbers, or if we remove some finite number of terms, then the behavior remains unaffected. The second property. Second property is, if a series in which all the terms are positive, if a series in which all the terms are positive, all the terms are positive and is convergent. See, second property is only for convergent, not for divergent. And is convergent, then the series remains convergent. The series remains convergent even when sum or all of its terms are negative. Sum or all of its terms are negative. What is the meaning of this? Let me consider one positive term series. Positive term series means each term is positive. All an greater than 0. Each term is positive. If this positive term is what? It is convergent, not for divergent. If this series is convergent, then an plus a2 minus a3 minus a4 minus a5 plus a6 minus a7, like this. If in this series, if I make some of the terms as negative, or I will convert every term to negative, then this series is also converges. That is the second axiom. What is that? If a positive term series is convergent, then if some of its terms are negative or all of its terms are negative, then the series remains convergent. This is second property. And the third one, last one, the convergence or divergence of an infinite series remains unchanged by multiplying each term by a fixed constant. Finite constant or number. That means what? Sigma an equal to a1 plus a2 plus an. One infinite series is there. Maybe positive terms, negative terms is alternate positive, negative, whatever it is. Then if I multiply each term of a series by k, that means kan, k2 and so on, is convergent or divergent, then k into an is also convergent or divergent. Okay. These are the three properties of the series. Any doubts? See, all of you, don't post the questions when I'm teaching classes. You can raise the questions. Okay. I cannot see the chat box while I am teaching. Any doubts?
Sir, are there any properties for oscillating series?
No. Yeah, one good doubt. See, this is, make a note for this. every what is that property? Every positive term series. Every positive term series. What is the meaning of positive term series? Means each term is positive. Every positive term series is either convergent or divergent. Every positive term series is what? Positive term series is either convergent or divergent. Never oscillates. In your syllabus, only positive term series and alternate series are there. Positive term series and alternate series, the last topic, that one. But every positive term series, either it converge or diverge, but never oscillates. This is one property. Next one. What is the next topic? Yeah, see, this is one important theorem which is very much useful in problems. Necessary condition for convergent. Instead of that, I will write the statement. If a positive term series, sigma an is convergent. What is that? Positive term series sigma an is convergent, then limit an n tends to infinity is definitely zero. See, this statement gives a meaning. Let me explain one by one. What is the point? First point is sigma an is convergent if positive term series, only positive term. If sigma an is convergent, then limit of nth term definitely zero. Catch my statement. What is that? I know sigma an is convergent series, then limit of nth term zero. Second point, if limit of nth term is zero, I'm taking directly the conclusion, limit of an equal to zero, then sigma an need not be convergent, maybe diverge also, need not be convergent. Okay, this is conclusion. See, what is that? If I know sigma an is convergent, yes, limit of nth term zero. But if limit of nth term zero, sigma an may be convergent, may not be convergent. And third point is important. Why this statement is useful? Third point, if limit an not equal to zero, limit an not equal to zero, then definitely sigma an is not converge. Definitely sigma an is not convergent. This is the main point. Actually, from this theorem statement, for every convergent series, limit of an equal to zero. But if limit of an not equal to zero, definitely it is not convergent. That is called necessary condition. And so my point is here, if limit an, n tends to infinity, not equal to zero, and sigma an is positive term series, then what is this one? When limit an not equal to zero, this is not convergent. And since it is positive term series, I made a statement. Every positive term series is either convergent or divergent. But limit an not equal to zero means not convergent. Therefore, this positive term series is definitely diverges, isn't it? Definitely diverges. Once again, I'm explaining, every positive term series is either converge or diverge. And if limit of an not equal to zero, then series not convergent. And if it is positive term series, definitely the series diverges. Any doubts? See the statement once again. If sigma an is convergent, the series is convergent, then limit of nth term zero. If limit of nth term not equal to zero, definitely the series not convergent. If limit of nth term zero, series may converge or may not converge. And final conclusion, if sigma, the series is positive term series and limit of an is not equal to zero, then series is divergent. Series is divergent. You have to remember this statement. This is very much useful in problems. Any doubts?
Sir, can you please explain the second statement where it need not be convergent?
Need not be convergent. Meaning, for example, see, I told this example.
Sir,
second one. Yeah.
Sir, I'm unable to hear you.
Is it audible now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, see, to understand the second concept, let me consider the series sigma n equal to sigma 1 by root n. Already we know this. 1 by root 1 plus 1 by root 2 and so on, right? What is this series? Actually, already we decided. We concluded the series is what? Divergent series, right? Just now we did this problem. Now, coming to here, what is nth term here? 1 over root n. Nth term is what? 1 over root n. What is limit n tends to infinity of an? Limit 1 over root n, n tends to infinity is what? 0. But already we proved that. But sigma 1 by root n is what? Divergent series. Divergent series. Already we proved. Right? For your clarity, I will show it once again. Yeah, this one. 1 by root n, 1 by root 1, right? Greater than 1 by root n, greater than 1 by root n, and you will get finally root n value. Okay, finally root n value. So Sn tends to infinity. Divergent series. Is that clear? Second one now. Nth term limit value is 0, but series need not be converge. Is doubt is clear?
Sir, for negative term series, sir?
Means, I'm not getting you. Negative terms means?
For positive term series, no, sir?
Yeah.
If every term is negative, these are
every term is negative, then see, if a series having every term as negative, okay, let us use this property. What is that property? I think second property. Second property, you convert every term to positive, then decide the convergence or convergence. Yes, if that positive term series is convergent, then complete negative term series also converge.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anyway, everything will be clear when we solving the problems. Okay. Now, one more. I will tell the proof of this statement after integral test, but you remember this. What is the statement? P series test, or this is also called as auxiliary series test. P series test or auxiliary series test. The statement is, the series sigma 1 by n power p, n is always from 1 to infinity. Means what? 1 by 1 power p, 1 by 2 power p, 1 by 3 power p, and nth term is 1 by n power p, and so on. Is series is clear first? What is the series? Sigma 1 by n power p. Clear? Then, first point, if p greater than 1, the series is convergent. P greater than 1, the series is convergent. Second point, if P less than or equal to 1, the series is divergent. P less than or equal to 1, the series is divergent. Okay, just example, just we consider one example now. What is that? Sigma 1 by root n, sigma 1 by root n. I can write this as n power 1 by 2. This is of what form? Is of the form sigma 1 by n power p, where p value is what? P value is what? This 1 by 2. P value 1 by 2. P value 1 by 2 means what? Less than 1. And what is the structure? Sigma 1 by n power p form. Sigma 1 by n power p form. P value 1 by 2 less than 1. Therefore, sigma 1 by root n is what series? Divergent series. Divergent series. This is the importance of P series test. Just by watching the series, if it is of the form 1 by n power p, 1 by n power p, and that power p is greater than 1, series is convergent. Less than or equal to 1, series is divergent. This is first example. If I consider second example, sigma 1 by n power 3 by 2. What is p value here? 3 by 2 greater than 1. Therefore, sigma 1 by n power 3 by 2 is what series? Convergent series. Convergent series. Third one, sigma 1 by n, what is the p value? 1. That implies sigma 1 by n is what series? Divergent series. Divergent series. Any doubts? This is the p series test. Remember, what is the structure must be? 1 by n power p. 1 by n power p. That p may be any number, any positive real number, maybe 0 also. Okay. Not 0. Greater than 1 or less than or equal to 1, and p must be greater than 0. P must be greater than 0. Remember this point, not negative. P must be greater than 0. This is the point. Any doubts in P series test? Yes, all of you are there.
Yes, sir.
Any doubts in P series?
No.
If P series is okay, then I will go for next one. I will tell the proof of this after integral test. Actually, no need of proof, but I will tell definitely. Shall I go for next one?
Yes, sir.
And the next one is comparison test. Next one is comparison tests. Comparison tests. Okay. In this one, the first one is comparison test 1. I will write comparison test 1. What is the statement? If sigma un, now I am changing the notation. Instead of sigma an, I am using sigma un. That's it, only that is a change. If sigma un and sigma vn are positive term series such that un is less than or equal to k into vn for all n, such that for all n un is less than or equal to k into vn for all n, and sigma vn is convergent, sigma vn is convergent, then sigma un also convergent. Then sigma un also convergent. I will explain this. See, what is this statement? Comparison. Comparison means what? Definitely comparison exists. exist between two terms or three terms or four terms. So definitely there must be at least two terms must be there for comparison. So remember that comparison test. There are I'm taking two series, sigma un and sigma vn. Both are positive term series. Both are positive term series. How this series were defined? The series un must be every term of un, every term of the series must be less than or equal to some constant into every term of the series sigma vn. Un is always less than or equal to k into vn. This is true for all n. K is some fixed constant. And remember, the inequality must be less than or equal to, first point. Second point, this right side series sigma vn, it must be convergent. Right side series sigma vn is convergent series. Then this left side series sigma un also convergent. Okay, once again, I'm considering two positive term series, un and vn. How they are exist? Every term of un is less than or equal to every term of vn. And this sigma vn right side term is series is convergent series, then left side series is also convergent. This is the first property. Second one, comparison test two.
Sir, for the comparison test one, the value of k, it should be positive or it can be negative also?
Positive, both are positive term series, no?
No, I'm talking about the value of constant k. It should be
definitely positive only. No? Definitely okay. Positive only because both are positive. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Right. Now, comparison test two. What is the statement? Comparison test two. If sigma un and sigma vn are positive term series such that un is greater than or equal to some k into vn for all n. What is that? Previously less than or equal to, now what is the symbol? Greater than or equal to. Un is greater than or equal to k into vn, and this right side series, this vn is divergent. Right side series sigma vn is divergent, then left side series sigma un also diverges. Left side series sigma un also diverges. So how to remember comparison test two? Un and vn are both positive term series. And the symbol is what? Greater than or equal to k into vn. Greater than or equal to k into vn. And this right side series is divergent. Then left side series is also diverges. This is comparison test 2. This is comparison test 2. Okay. And the next one. Third one. This is important. Third one. This is called limit comparison test. Limit comparison test. What is this test? Limit comparison test statement. If sigma un and sigma vn are positive term series such that remember this, such that limit un by vn as n tends to infinity. What is this? Un by vn as n tends to infinity is L, some limit value L. Then first point, if L value, L is finite and sigma vn, this sigma vn is convergent. L is finite and sigma vn is convergent, then sigma un also converges. Then sigma un also convergent. What is this one? This limit value L, this value is L is finite and unique, and this denominator series sigma vn is convergent, then sigma un also convergent. Second point. If L is infinite, L value is infinite, and sigma Vn is divergent. Sigma Vn is divergent, then sigma Un also diverges. Sigma Un also diverges. Okay, this is limit comparison test. Idea, what is that? Limit Un by Vn, this value is L, n tends to infinity. Okay, if this L is finite and sigma Vn converge, then sigma un also converge, first statement. And this is infinite and sigma Vn is diverge, then sigma un also diverge. Sigma un also diverge. Okay, this is limit comparison test. Totally we have three tests. One is comparison test one, another one is comparison test two, and another one is limit comparison test. Totally three comparison tests are there. Okay, for tomorrow's class you must be thorough with all these statements. First one is geometric series statement, next one P series statement, and this comparison test, and this comparison test. Three statements: comparison test one, test two, and test three, that is limit comparison test. Now class is open for doubts,
sir.
Yeah,
in the geometric test, sir, second point I have doubts, sir.
Okay, one minute. Yeah, tell second point, which one?
Second point, sir.
Yes, mod r greater than or equal to 1.
Yes, sir.
Right?
You said mod r is greater than or equal to 1. And in that, r value will be also less than minus 1, no, sir? Third case or second case will...
R value?
R value can be minus 1, no, sir? Then mod r is 1.
Where?
In second case, sir. If r value is minus 1 or minus 2.
You are taking plus or minus, huh?
Then mod r means we can take plus or minus, no, sir? It doesn't
matter.
So third case and second case will mismatch, no, sir?
No, not like that. For example, see, as per your doubt, what is mod r less than 1 in first case?
From minus 1 to 1, any r value.
Yeah, minus 1 to 1. What is r is less than 1 and r is greater than minus 1?
Yes, sir.
R is greater than minus 1, all right?
Yes,
and
sir.
when we consider r greater than minus 1, is it there in third case r greater than minus 1 is there? No, r less than r equal to minus 1, third case.
Yes, sir. Here r can be minus 2, no, sir? Third case.
Maybe minus 2, no problem.
In second case also it can be minus 2, no, sir?
In second case, this is, you can write plus r minus r greater than r equal to 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Right, so r is greater than 1 and minus r is greater than 1 means r is less than negative 1. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, then also diverge. No,
they're divergent. You have given divergent here, it is oscillating also.
No, wait, plus r minus r is less than minus 1.
Sir, just remove the mod, sir. Only r greater than or equal to 1.
Then it is coming, sir. Yes.
So that means it is in a oscillate series, alternate series, it is valid.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
And then this example is not valid. This example. We are considering mod r only.
Yes, sir. That is
convergent, sir.
That is first case, sir.
First case, right. So in second case, I have to remove mod, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good doubt. All of you, remove mod in second case. In statement. Here also statement. Right. Any more doubts? Very good.
Sir, examples for comparison test, sir.
Examples for?
Comparison test, 1 and 2.
Baba, it's already 3-5.
Okay, sir. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow I will tell. That's what I'm telling. Thorough with those statements. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Just give me attendance pass line one by one. One.
Present, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Three. Rule number three. Next, four. Four. Three, Ananya. Ananya, I think you are there. 57 members are there. 56.
They are speaking, but the mic is not working for them.
Right. Rule number four. Similarly, for Anjali Barga also.
Yes, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six.
Present, sir.
Seven.
Present, sir.
Emma, Nagakshita, doubt la adagaledi roju.
Sir, three present, sir. I got disconnected, sir, in between.
Okay, rule number four. Eight, rule number eight. Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Sir, four present, sir.
Yes?
Four, rule number four, sir, present.
Okay, rule number eight. Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17. 18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24.
Present, sir.
25.
Present, sir.
26.
Present, sir.
27.
Present, sir.
28.
Present, sir.
29.
Present, sir.
30. 30. 30. 31. 32.
Present, sir.
33.
Present, sir.
34.
Present, sir.
35.
Present, sir.
36.
Present, sir.
37.
Present, sir.
38.
Present, sir.
39.
Present, sir.
40.
Present, sir.
41.
Present, sir.
42. 43.
Present, sir.
44.
Present, sir.
45.
Present, sir.
46. 46.
Present, sir.
47.
Present, sir.
48.
Present, sir.
49.
Present, sir.
50.
Present, sir.
51.
Present, sir.
52.
Present, sir.
53.
Present, sir.
54.
Present, sir.
55.
Present, sir.
56.
Present, sir.
57.
Present, sir.
58.
Present, sir.
Okay. Students, YouTube channel chustunnara? Lesson vintunnara?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, subscribe cheyandi.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Yeah. Okay.
Sure, fine. Sir.
We'll meet tomorrow, right?
Thank you, sir.